For they say that the sirens were persuaded to compete in singing with the muses, and that the muses, being victorious, plucked off the sirens' wings and made crowns from them.
That's ridiculous! How could we possibly lose a singing competition?
Because the song of the muses has substance. They don't just sit around caterwauling at any hapless passerby, trying to ensnare him with deadly charms. They convey information. They articulate meaning. They enunciate. Sing to me, O muse. O muses, guide my pen. To the heavenly muses do I entrust my art. Ever invokes the sirens.
I don't understand why the muses think they can take credit for everything.
Because they can. They practically have a monopoly on the liberal arts. I mean, look, you've got Cleo, muse of history. Mel Palmetto, muse of tragedy.
Talia, muse of comedy.
Euterpe, muse of epic poetry. Calliope, muse of lyric poetry.
Errato, muse of erotic poetry.
Polyhymnia, muse of the hymn. Urania, muse of the stars. Terpsichore, muse of the dance.
According to different genealogies. For example, hit it.
Luca Mia!
White goddess.
Driven mad by Hera as punishment for sheltering the infant Dionysus.
Parthenope!
Virgin voice. One.
Also an eponymous Greek settlement absorbed into the modern day city of Naples.
Voiced one,
also the name of Sin, a moon in the lake of Saturn, and an Edgar Allan Poe.